Over the last 4 years, more than 250 Americans have left this country to join ISIS and other Islamic terror groups. And the U.S. government isn't stopping them.
That's the finding from a new congressional report, which also says some of these would-be terrorists could come back to launch attacks here at home. Dale Hurd has the story.
The 65-page congressional report says the White House lacks a strategy to prevent Americans from traveling abroad to join terrorist groups like ISIS, or to catch those who return to the U.S. with a plan to commit terror attacks, or to stop their recruitment in the first place. The study says of the hundreds of Americans who have sought to travel to the conflict zone in Syria and Iraq, authorities have only blocked a fraction. To make matters worse, several dozen potential terrorists have managed to make it back into the U.S. The report said of special concern are Western European Muslims who have gone to Iraq or Syria to fight and can then fly to the U.S. without applying for a visa. At a UN terrorism summit Tuesday, world leaders discussed the ongoing problem of Muslims who travel to the Middle East to fight with the Islamic State.
Our most recent data shows a 70% of increase in foreign terrorist fighters from over 100 countries to regions in conflict.
The report's damning conclusion is that the U.S. lacks a national strategy for combating terrorist travel and has not produced one in nearly a decade. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Well, in other news, Kentucky clerk Kim Davis had an unexpected meeting with one of the most famous people in the world last week. John Jessup has that story from our CBN News Bureau in Washington. John?
That's right, Gordon. Kim Davis says she and her husband met with the Pope for less than 15 minutes at the Vatican Embassy here in Washington. Davis reports Pope Francis spoke to her in English and said, "Thank you for your courage and stay strong." Davis recently spent 5 days in jail for refusing to obey a court order to issue marriage licenses to same-sex couples in Round County, Kentucky, because of her Christian faith. You'll want to stay tuned tomorrow for an in-depth interview with Kim Davis from CBN's David Brody on tomorrow's 700 Club. Well, it may not have forced a government shutdown, but Planned Parenthood was the center of a showdown on Capitol Hill, where congressional Republicans demanded answers from the abortion provider's president in a hearing that lasted more than 5 hours. The questions focused on those undercover videos and how the group spends taxpayer dollars it gets from Washington. Paul Strand has the story.
Planned Parenthood. This hearing wasn't just about those controversial tapes showing possible wrongdoing, but whether Planned Parenthood should keep getting more and more federal taxpayer dollars over the years. The Republican chair of the hearing said definitely not, especially with the cuts in care Planned Parenthood's made in the last decade.
There's a 53% reduction in cancer screenings, 42% reduction in breast exams and breast care.
Republicans suggested moving those federal dollars to more worthy recipients.
We simply want to shift the money from an organization caught doing what they were caught doing and give it to the community health centers. Shift it from the 700 Planned Parenthood clinics, give it to the 13,000 federally approved community health centers. Take the money from the guys doing the bad things and give it to the ones who aren't.
Republicans accomplished their goal of launching a multi-pronged attack on Planned Parenthood, but its leader fought back with a spirit of defense.
The outrageous accusations leveled against Planned Parenthood based on heavily doctored videos are offensive and categorically untrue.
The videos are not edited, they're not manipulated. The full version of these videos are posted online.
The committee holding this hearing is one of four congressional panels scrutinizing Planned Parenthood and the more than $500 million it gets every year from the federal government. Paul Strand, CBN News, Capitol Hill.
And Gordon, the fight is far from over. Outgoing House Speaker John Boehner has created a special committee to investigate Planned Parenthood.
Well, let's hope they move forward with it, but it's a classic defense. Attack your accuser and start saying it's an outrageous accusation, we would never do anything like this, and then start talking about how heavily doctored or heavily edited the video is. I saw last night a news anchor on a news channel accuse somebody, well, where's your evidence that they did anything illegal? As if these videotape, that kind of evidence isn't sufficient. It's absolutely incredible to me the spin that's happening here and why the American people aren't rising up to say enough of this. We should not be selling baby parts That is abhorrent to us as a culture. Please let us stop. But as long as this kind of spin exists, and the amazing thing is they seem to be getting away with it. No one seems to be calling them on, well, where specifically is it edited, and what in the world are you talking about here when you say you can get these kinds of parts and you know specific ways to do procedures in order to harvest them. What in the world are you meaning there, and how much money is being exchanged, and where's the investigation of those finances? That's where it is, and from my lawyer days, you always follow the money, and when you find the money, you find out who paid the money and what were they paying the money for and who did it go to. When you have that kind of detail, and hopefully Congress can get to that level, you'll find out the real story. But as long as this spin is out there, good grief, well, can we ever get to a level to say, please let us not sell baby parts?